Welcome to this brief guide on how to use pivot tables and charts in Google Sheets. One thing that tends to strike fear into many whenever they are asked if they know how to make one is pivot tables. But today, I'm going to show you how you can not only design and make one easily, I will also show you how you can then leverage it to make your very own interactive dashboard in mere moments using pivot charts. Here I have Google Sheets open with my raw sales data for 2023. I have been tasked with creating a 2023 sales dashboard from this data. My sales spreadsheet for the year is packed with a lot of information, almost 1600 lines of it in fact. It's great to have all of this data available to me, but I can't easily see the big picture. Which regions are outperforming others? What patterns exist across different product categories? And so on. That's where knowing how to make pivot tables can become a lifesaver. Let's create our first pivot table. I'll start by selecting a cell in my raw sales data table, go to the Insert menu in the toolbar, and choose the option for Pivot Table. This gives us a pop-up to create a new table. You'll see that my entire table has been auto-selected as the source to be used here. I can adjust this and choose a different area if I wish. When doing so, there will be some suggested sets of data based on your spreadsheet, which we will make use of later in this video. I'll elect to put it on a new sheet to keep things organized. Now I choose Create to make my pivot table, and Sheets automatically moves me over to the new sheet it has created for my table. But the pivot table is looking pretty bare at the moment and needs me to select the data to use in it. We can do this using the pivot table editor found here on the right. The first column here is showing what items are currently being used in my pivot table, and the second column contains a list of all of the items from the headers of my raw sales data. I want to start by comparing each sales region, so I'll add sales region under rows by simply dragging that item over to the rows area. For this example, I don't need to see the grand total, so I will untick the show totals option. And I want to break the sales results down by category to see which brought in the most revenue. So category goes under columns. There seems to be one super important thing missing from my pivot table at the moment though, and that is the actual sales. I'll add total revenue under values. By default, it sums the revenue, which is perfect for what we need here. And there we go. Our pivot table instantly shows the revenue from sales for each category within each region. This was way faster than any manual calculations I may have previously done, and nowhere near as daunting as it may have originally seemed. But it's currently still just a table. Let's make this even more intuitive and visual with a pivot chart. I'll select any cell in my pivot table, go back to the Insert menu, and pick Chart. A column chart has been chosen automatically and seems perfect for comparing our regional sales totals. But you can easily use the options in the chart editor on the right and select another table type if you prefer. But whilst this is nice, it doesn't really give me all the information I need. Let's investigate our sales reps. Who's bringing in the most revenue for the company? This is where we will want to create a second pivot table. A lot of people would think we'd need to jump back to our raw data to do this, but using a feature I mentioned earlier in this video, we don't have to. We can just jump back to the Insert menu and select Pivot Table. This time, we need to choose the option to change the data range. We can see our raw sales data right there in the suggested area for us to select. And this time, we will choose to keep it on the same sheet as our current pivot table. We need to choose where to place it, and I'm going to throw it up in row 1 alongside our other pivot table. And then we click Create, and our second pivot is ready to customize. Just like last time, we need to choose the items for our table from the selection in the pivot table editor. Since we are wanting to compare our sales reps this time, the sales representative option gets placed under rows. And for this one, I don't really need to break this down by any particular columns, so all we need now is the values selection. Again, just like our first pivot, we'll add total revenue to values. Now I can instantly see who's generating the most revenue. Pivot tables have quickly turned our messy data into super clear insights for us. To visualize our sales rep performance in a chart alongside our other one, we head to Insert and select Chart. It's given us a column chart, but I think a pie chart might be a better option for this data. I select the chart type option and we can see that a pie chart is among the suggested options. This is great for showing what percentage of total revenue each rep contributes. And whilst these two charts are great at giving me an overall view of aspects of my business, they are mostly just static images at the moment. I don't want to be making multiple versions of these just to filter the data for different time periods, etc. And I promised earlier on that we would make these interactive. So let's do that now. The magic trick that makes these charts go from static to interactive is slices. For this, we will need to head to the Data tab in the toolbar and select the option to add a slicer. This gives us a pill-shaped item that is telling us to select the column first that we want this to filter for. This is also done over here on the right, but we see straight away that it has chosen our second pivot table, which means we don't have all of our columns to choose from. We solve this by changing our data range. And similar to before, we see our raw sales data among the suggested data sets alongside our two pivot tables. Select the full data set and select OK. Now when we head back over to the column selector for our first slicer, we will see all the options from our table. This is going to give us a lot of power when combined with our charts and slices. I'll start by choosing sales quarter for the first slicer, and then be sure the box is ticked to apply to pivot tables. I will then move this one over to the side, just above our two charts. We'll come back to it in just a moment, but first, we are going to make a couple more slices. This will allow us to get really granular with our filtering of data. The first slicer is breaking down the times when sales occurred, so we will make our second one break down the regions where the sales happened. And then I'll move this one over next to the first one. And then we follow the same steps for our third and final slicer for this demonstration. For this one, I think we should break the data down based on the product category, so we choose the category option. This will help me to see if particular sales reps are excelling at selling particular product categories. I'll then grab this last one and move it neatly next to the other two. And now we are ready to start slicing up the data. Where this becomes really useful to us is that this is going to turn these two very static charts into responsive elements that change based on what we do with the slices. I'll start by filtering my sales quarter option. Let's say I only want to see how we do around the holiday periods. I can untick both Q2 and Q3, leaving only Q1 and Q4 selected. The moment I select OK, we see the two charts animate and shift to show me the results of my filtered data. But it doesn't stop there. I made multiple different slices for a reason. Now I will filter my sales region selection down to just the West region. This allows me to see the same data I saw before for them in the first chart, but my second chart is now showing me how Page has brought in the most revenue from customers in the West region for Q1 and Q4 combined. And then lastly, I can filter the product category section just to see the electronics split in revenue. And we can easily see that Page accounts for over 32% of the revenue from the electronics category for the West region across Q1 and Q4 combined. This is like having our own customizable mini dashboard. And if I needed any of these charts as an image to use elsewhere, I can simply use the ellipsis menu in the top right corner of my chart and use the option to download chart. I have options for PNG, PDF, and even SVG files. And a personal favorite option of mine for when I'm needing to present charts like these is to move the chart to its own sheet. This makes it nice and large, which is great for when you are screen sharing via Teams or Zoom. And you can flick between charts by simply selecting the different sheets down at the bottom. And what's more is that we can head back to our pivot table sheet where our slices are located and make changes to the filtered options. Here I am going to reselect all of the elements in all three of the slices. And even though the charts are no longer located on this sheet with the slices, when we click over to see the charts, we can see that they have still updated for us based on the updated filters. And the same goes for our second chart also. And finally, if we were to head back to our raw sales data sheet and make any changes to the data here, for example, changing the data in the table for 2024's sales data, it would then in turn populate through to our pivot tables, both of which are referencing that data. And those changes in the pivot tables then flow through to our two pivot charts automatically also, thus making it super easy to find and showcase data insights from our huge pile of data in mere minutes. And that is the power of pivot tables and pivot charts. I hope you found this guide extremely useful and it has helped you to feel more comfortable with making your own pivot tables and charts in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.